Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I know the lighting is crazy. I am sitting in my kitchen with just my kitchen light on and with my red walls and everything. It makes the lighting in here kind of wacky on camera. But even though the camera lighting is crazy, this is the actual color of my hair. Yes, my hair is purple temporarily. I'm actually in the process of going blonde. I bleached my hair, and if you can tell right here, some of the purple didn't grab on as good. But this is just like a semi-permanent color. It's supposed to wash out after 6 weeks. And I really wanted purple hair for a while now, but not like permanently, but just a trot. And I know once I actually get to like platinum blonde hair that I'm not going to want to change it or put color on top of it. So I did bleach it, but it wasn't completely, it still had some like orangey brassy tones in it. So I went ahead and covered it with the purple. And then I'm going to let this fade a little bit and then bleach it again until I get it to the color I want, and then just leave it for a while. So yeah, that's kind of the plan. I don't know how it's going to look on me. I may look like I'm 90 years old, but that's what we're going for now. But anyway, the reason I'm in my kitchen is because my husband is upstairs in bed. It is almost midnight, 15 till in fact, and he has to be up in just a few hours. So I figured my nose is itching. I'm not picking it, I promise. That is off camera only. Okay, so anyway, he has to be up in a few hours, so I figured I would film down here so that he could try to get some sleep without me being in the next room talking. Also, my little boy is here in the living room watching his movie, Paddington, that we watch every single day. I'm not kidding, we watch it every day, multiple times. Some days we watch it about 4 times, and he actually sits and watches most of it. There'll be times that he'll go like to his playroom, play with some toys for a few minutes, but if I would turn it off, it would upset him. So he has to have his movie on. And we're actually really excited because this year they don't have the release date yet. I don't think they've even started filming, but it is supposed to come out in 2017. They're having a Paddington 2, which I'm totally excited about, and it is going to be the same actors, which I highly appreciate. That's one of the things that get me is when they come out with sequels and it's different actors. And I understand sometimes, you know, they can't get the same actors for movies, but it's just one of my pet peeves. And I already did look. It is supposed to be the same actors in it. And that's my kitchen chair squeaking. But I think it'll probably come out around his birthday too, because his birthday is in November. And since they haven't actually started filming yet, I'm guessing it's going to be close to the end of the year before it is ready. So yeah, I'm really excited to take him to see that. The reason for this video is actually a mini haul. I don't even think I've mentioned that yet. Oh. No, this is not beer. This is Diet Sam's Cola. I do not drink beer. That is against everything that I believe in. So, just so you know, because me and my husband always joke that these look like beer cans, and anytime we take them in the car with us, we're like, we're totally going to get pulled over because they're going to think we're drinking and driving. But it's just pop. She'll just really thirsty. Okay, so I went shopping today with my mom. It was actually, she had to go to her dermatologist to get some skincare, and we just went to the mall and stuff. This lighting is awful. The more I look at it, I'm just like, ugh. Oh well, it's okay. It's okay. I don't even know if you've seen this part of my kitchen. I know that I did a DIY, how to distress t-shirts, and I was actually wearing this exact same shirt in that video. This was the shirt I distressed, so that's kind of weird, but I promise I don't wear this shirt all the time. This is only the second time I've worn it, so it's just a coincidence. But anyway, this is my kitchen. That's in front of me, you can see part of it. This is my kitchen counter. We have bar stools. That is my candle holder and candle heater up here. I use that because I don't like to light candles very much because I have cats. I'm afraid they'll knock it over. I do light the little candle in my beauty room when I'm filming and stuff, but that's it. This back here is just some pictures of me and my husband and my sister when I was pregnant. We had maternity pictures taken, and we was pregnant at the same time, so we had some pictures taken. And then over here, this is just a little wooden thing with lights in it, and it's got some pictures in it as well. And then this side over here is my like sink and stove and refrigerator and all that. Anyway, I don't know why I'm talking about this. This is supposed to be a mini haul that was going to like be 5 minutes long, but it's turning into a 30 minute long chit chat nothing. So hope you enjoy free video. Okay, so anyway, first place, Sephora. I just got one thing, and I was in there for like an hour just looking around, and there were several things I wanted, but they didn't have them. I really want to get the YSL, the Shock mascara. I want to try that out, but they don't carry it at my Sephora. Did they not carry YSL makeup in Sephora's? I thought they did, but I guess not. I don't know, but they didn't have it at mine. But mine is one of the Sephora's that's like inside of JCPenney, so it may not have as much. And also, it doesn't carry Hourglass. So that was surprising, because I wanted to the stick foundation. I wanted to try that, but they didn't have that either. So yeah, whatever. We got one thing, and it is the Urban Decay Vice Special Effects Long Lasting Water Resistant Lip Top Coat. And I got it in the shade Regulate. I do have it on my lips on top of my red lipstick right now. This does dry down, so it gives you like a sparkly, shiny, hold on, I dropped my receipt. Okay. So it gives you shiny, glittery awesomeness, and it dries down though. So I don't know how this would work if you put it on top of a regular lipstick that wasn't matte, but I just have it over top of a liquid lipstick. And it's so pretty. They had 8 different shades, but this was just the one I liked. Did I tell you the name? Regulate is the name. And it's kind of like a purpley silver, and it just has a regular little brush applicator. And basically, it's purpley, silvery glitter that goes on your lips and dries down. It's awesome. And if I look like I have Joker mouth, that's because I do, because I went to go put this red lipstick on, and I was putting my red lip liner on, and me with lip liner is like me trying to do winged eyeliner. Like, it gets bigger and bigger, and then I try to like match it to the other side. Before you know, my lip liner is up to my nose, and so yeah, they're completely way overdrawn. My lips are not naturally this big, and I look like a clown, but it's okay. You all love me anyway, and that's just the truth of life. And some people overdraw their lips anyway. I'm just personally not one of those people, so I think it looks funny on me when I do, but what is. Anyway, the top coat was $18, $19.08 after tax, and that is the only thing I got in Sephora after looking around for an hour. Okay, so next I went to Rue 21, and I did get a couple things, if I can get them out of y'all. And actually, I spent $25 at Rue and saved $26. Hold on, I can tell you exactly, probably on my receipt. I spent $25.94, and it said that I saved, does it not tell me on my receipt? Because it told me when I checked out. $26.50. So I got everything over half off. Basically, one of the things that I was buying was $24.99. So I basically got the other two items for free. So that's completely awesome. So the first thing that I saw as soon as I got in the store, and my mom did too actually, she bought the same pair, are these ripped shorts. And they're all like jaggedy and holey. And I liked them because they're a little bit high-waisted, like not like, you know, mom jean high-waisted, but I am very long. And I have like a lot of, to just say it, butt. I have a lot of butt. And if I don't watch, my butt crack likes to hang out in jeans or pants if I don't have them high enough. So I cannot do like low rise jeans ever. And so these are kind of like a mid to high rise pants. Actually, I don't know what it says. If it says high or what, it doesn't. Anyway, I don't know how you pronounce the brand, if that's Celo or Cello. I really don't know. It's C-E-L-L-O. That is the actual brand. And they are running extremely small. My mom wears a 0 and she had to get a size 4. So they are like extreme, and it may just be the fit where they do kind of come up a little bit. I don't know, but they are running very, very small. I got a size 13. Size 13. And normally I wear like a 9. So yeah, but they don't look like a 13 and definitely do not fit like a 13. But I like them because they are a little bit longer, because I am more on the modest side. I'm not the kind to wear really short shorts or low-cut shirts. It's just not how I was raised, or, you know, it's just against me, myself as a person. I don't do that. And, you know, if you do, to each his own, but it's just not my kind of thing. But I really like these because they were raggedy and a good length, and they come up high enough. So I got these, and they were $24.99. Totally love them. Now I need a drink of pop. Okay, so they had a buy one, get one half off sale. And then there was like a coupon. If you spent so much, you got so much off. So the next two items I got free, actually. And I'd actually already picked them out and was planning on paying for them before I realized there was the other coupon. And the first one is a Nickelodeon shirt. It was between this one and one that was like a peachy color, like kind of coral, light coral. And it said Hey Arnold with the Hey Arnold cast on it. But this one is just Nickelodeon and it has them on it, but it also has some Rugrats characters. It has Rocco. It has a bunch of different ones. To be honest, I didn't even stop and look at it. It has Reptar, which I totally appreciate. But it was a big Nickelodeon fan. It had Chucky and Tommy. So Rugrats and Hey Arnold were my favorite cartoons in the 90s. I also really liked Doug. Doug. You don't see enough of Doug. My kid's being really quiet. I'm going to check on him. Okay, so he was just being really good. But when you have a toddler and they're being quiet, you get very suspicious. And I know you're probably wondering why my kid's still up at midnight. We do not go to bed early. And he's just now starting to wind down a little bit. But he just kind of got on my sleeping schedule. And I like it that way. So, yeah. Anyway, I just thought it was cute. It took me back to my childhood. I did get it in a large. I tried it on in a medium and that fit, but I just like things looser, so I got it in a large. So, yeah, that's just the way I roll. Okay, and the next thing I picked out, I totally thought was adorable, and I also got it in a large. And it's just this really long gray tank top, and on the corner it has this little cat, and it says, "Stop stressing me out." And I thought it was so cute. And I love cats, so I have 2. And I low-key kind of want another one. And I won't let myself have one, but I kind of want one. I especially want another hairless one. But I don't need another hairless one because, one, they're expensive. 2, they... Really, there's nothing, no downside to hairless cats other than they're expensive. But 2, I don't get to give the one that I have as much attention as she is used to having since I've had the baby. Because before the baby, she was the baby. And she still gets attention, like she still sleeps with me every night and stuff like that. But she doesn't just get my non-stop attention at all times like she used to. And she's in no way neglected, like she has a good life. She's pampered and, you know, she's fed and gets like love and attention, but just not like she was used to. And even though I would get, if I got another cat, it would be used to the way our schedule is, but I feel like it would just take attention away from the ones I have even more. Now my other cat, Lovey, she doesn't want attention. She doesn't want to be held. She doesn't want picked up. If she comes to you and sits next to you, fine, pet her head, whatever. But she's not like the kind to sit and like purr while you pet her. As long as she's got food and water and is basically left to herself, she's happy. That's the way she likes it. She's kind of grouchy. But my other one is kind of on the needy side. But yeah. Okay, so this was kind of a pointless video, bad lighting quality, and I've talked for 30 minutes. But I hope you all enjoyed anyway. What are you doing? I see you in there. Oh my goodness. I'm going to show you the baby. I'll show you the babes. Hi there. Hi, suckers. Hi there, suckers. Hold on. We have Gates. Look at all the pillows on the... Whoops. That was my tripod. Look at all the pillows on the couch. Except for that right there. That's my diaper bag, the other leopard thing. And that's my flip-flop that my kid just stuck there. He's eating cheese puffs. We have a Gate because he's not allowed in the kitchen area because he wants to play with the candles, and I'm always afraid he will knock them over. And also, there's my refrigerator. If you look in there, that is the doggies room, and then there's a door right here that goes down into my basement. So I'll just keep this gated off because there's just a lot of things he doesn't need to be into. Say hi. Say hi. He's getting that sleepy look. Oh, that's so sweet. Blow sugar. Blow him sugar. Blow it. Go mwah. With your hand. Ah, that's so good. Alright, y'all. I love you guys. I hope you've enjoyed. I'm going to get this little rascal to sleep. And, wash my face and go to sleep myself. Hey, baby, tell him bye. Say bye.